Hi guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in this series of morning tales. I hope that you are doing very well in your preparations for examinations. So let's begin this series without wasting any time, and I have a lot of interesting questions for you, so don't leave this video in the middle. Now, those who are coming for the first time, I would like them to subscribe to this channel and hit this bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group where we share prerequisites as well as we resolve the queries of students. So here is our first question. Who among the following is known as the father of Indian IT industry? So recently this personality has passed away. So this is basically a question from obituary, and obituaries are important. They are asked in the examinations as well in the past. So you have to remember that who is the eminent personality that has recently passed away? What was his profession, nationality, or what is the thing that he or she was famous for? So these are some of the things that you should remember from obituary section, and that obituary section is provided in the miscellaneous section of Spotlight magazine. Now this question is very important because it is about the father of Indian IT industry. So who is that person? The right answer is Fakir Chand Kohli. He is also known as FCK in IT industry. Now guys, he is that magnanimous personality that pioneered TCS. TCS is Tata Consultancy Service. So we all have heard about such a great company, and he is the person that has led that company to such magnitude. Now, now in the options, you should also know that all these people are father of some of the, are the pioneers of some of the great field in India. For example, Raja Ram Ravi Verma is the father of Indian modern painting. Now your task is to find out that these are the pioneers of which field. They are known as the father of which field in India. So that is your task for the day, and remember these names because these are important. And this one has been talked by me in one of the previous sessions of Morning Tales itself. So I hope that you will answer all the questions in the comment section below. Now let's move on to the next question. Who among the following has won the Social Entrepreneur of the Year Award 2020? So this award has been recently given to the co-founder of Prabha and Community Organization. So Prabha and Community are two organizations. So basically the Social Entrepreneur of the Year Award has been given to Ashraf Patel, who is the co-founder of Prabha and Community, for her work in the field of youth entrepreneurship and leadership, for developing youth entrepreneurship and leadership. Now guys, do you know that which organization gives this award? This award is given by Scope Foundation for Social Entrepreneurship, which is based in Switzerland, as well as Jubilant Bharatiya Foundation. So this is an Indian foundation. So these two have collaborated to give this award. And this award is not new. It has been given since 2010. So that's it for this question. And now it's time for us to discuss the third question. Who has been appointed as the brand ambassador of the state of West Bengal? So this reminds me the brand ambassador or the state icon of Punjab. Now who is that person? You have to tell me in the comment section below, because I have discussed it in one of the morning tales previously. So it is now a test for you. You have to tell me that who is that person that has been recently appointed as a state icon of Punjab. Now let's come back to the West Bengal. So the right answer is Shah Rukh Khan. So it's a very basic, simple question of an appointment. Nothing to discuss much. Just remember Shah Rukh Khan is the brand ambassador of West Bengal. Where is Indian Navy's Information Management and Analysis Center located? So guys, IMAC, that is Information Management and Analysis Center, it was set up in 2014. Basically, it was operationalized in 2014 after the 2611 attack. Mumbai attack. So in order to prevent such attacks from repeating itself in the future, this center has been established, which looks into the coordination among the Indian Navy and Coast Guard. So they basically, this center is for establishing link between Indian Navy and Indian Coast Guard in order to prevent such kind of terror attacks from repeating themselves. Now, where is it located? It is located in Gurgaon. Now you must be thinking that it is such an old organization or center. It was set up so long back as in 2014. Then why are we discussing it again? The reason behind that is that this recently it has been announced that Navy's Information Management Analysis Center will be developed, will be upgraded into National Maritime Domain Awareness Center. So this will be upgraded into this National Maritime Domain Awareness Center, and obviously after upgradation the activities and the scope of this or this center is definitely going to expand, and this will increase vigilance of Indian Navy and Indian Coast Guard on the Indian seas in order to prevent terror attacks from happening in the future again. So that's all for this question. Now my question is that who is the Minister of Shipping? As well as the Director General of Shipping. So these are the two questions for you guys, and both of these questions have been discussed by me. So you have to tell me these two questions in the comment section. Next question is, which company has acquired 100% equity stake of Mahindra First Choice Limited and its subsidiary Auto Digitech Private Limited? This is a very basic question of an acquisition, and it has been done by TVS Automobile Solutions. So 100% stake acquisition it is, and it has been done in this company. So that's all for this question. Nothing to be remembered more. Just remember these three facts. Next question is, who has been appointed as a chairperson of International Cricket Council, ICC? So those who are cricket lover out there, this question is a very happening thing for them. So guys, do you know that who is the chairperson of ICC? It is Greg Barclay. Now, from which country does he belong to? That is your task to find out. Find out and give mention it in the comment section below. With which company has India recently signed an MOU for cooperation in the field of environment protection and biodiversity conservation? So, an MOU has been signed by India with another country in the field of biodiversity protection, conservation, and environment protection. Now, this much is the information that you need to keep in your mind. If you remember too many things, you will end up forgetting the main news itself. So just restrict yourself to the main news, that is this MOU between India and Finland in the field of environment protection and biodiversity conservation. Now, whenever there is an MOU with another country, what is your responsibility? Your responsibility is to mug up the static facts about that country. What are the static facts? PM, capital, and currency. So these are the three static facts that you have to remember from this country, Finland, and you will be mentioning it in the comment section below. So guys, we have the legend of football world, the immortal legend of football world in front of us. So he is Diego Maradona. He passed away last week only, and this picture of him, this quote of him is here because this is the message from his as well as from me for you guys, that if you are depending on your luck for success, then wake up. Luck has no role to play in your success. It's your hard work that will leverage you to success. So that's it that Diego Maradona has to say, and your mentor, that is me, also has to say this thing to you. And I know that majority of you are doing a really hard work, but those of your friends who are not doing that work, you should share this lecture with them as well, so that they can also get the idea, they can also get the inspiration to transform their lives. So that is what I wanted to say from this personality. And he's a very great person in actuality, because PM Narendra Modi himself expressed condolence on his passing away. So you can yourself judge this thing. Now the next question is from him only. So the next question is, which country does Diego Maradona belong to? So as we know that he belongs to football, but what is his nationality? It is Argentine. So he belongs to Argentine. Now your task is to tell me the capital and currency of this country. Argentine, because these are the static facts that you should be aware of about the foreign countries. Next question. This question is a homework kind of thing for you, because I'm not going to tell you the answer of this question. You must have heard about the Chinese apps that are being banned by the government continuously. Recently, 43 or I guess 46 apps have been banned by Indian government. But guys, do you know under which section of IT Act are they being banned? This is your question to find out. Do find it out and tell this to me in the comment section below. So this is the time that we should say goodbye to each other. Thank you so much for watching this session. I hope that you have really liked it. And if you have, then do share it with your friends and like this video. Thank you.